Hello and welcome, my name is Kai from cloudsart.co.uk. If you've been with me before, you know what I'm all about. Yes, step-by-step free lessons. Yes, if you want to paint something like that, this is what you're going to be doing today with myself in the studio. Please stay with me after this very short introduction. You can come and join me there and we can get down and start painting. Nice.
Hey, welcome, thanks for stopping by. It's time to learn with our friend Clive. So grab your brush, have a great time.
Hello, and thank you for watching the introduction. And don't joining forget me in the studio today. Now, we're going to be working on a canvas, which is, let's just get my measuring stick device. It is a 10 by 12. Yes, 10 by 12. And as you know, the conversions for that in centimetres or millimetres is in descriptions. Yes, so let's have a look at the colours we're going to be using today. I'm going to take my hat off as well. And as you know, all the colours are going up the right hand side of the screen as a normal. We've got a black, a white, a titanium white, Mars black, it could be any black, doesn't matter. I've got a cadmium red, a burnt umber, Van Dyke brown, yellow ochre, cadmium yellow medium, and some hookers green. They are there on the cards if you want to have a little look at that during the video. But they're there for my use as well. I'm also going to be using some medium mix flow improver. I'm going to put a dozen or so squirts in there, and that is a liquid that has got a polymer resin in it, so it stops the paint from being underbound. Underbinding is when the, I can add a little bit of water to that, and that's all the moisture I'm going to be using in the video today. Underbinding basically means that if you over thin acrylic, what happens is the acrylic polymers, the more water you add to it, the further they are pulled apart. So when the water evaporates and the acrylic settles onto the surface and dries out, because that's what it is basically. The paint is made up with a lot of water as well, so the water evaporates, but it leaves a polymer resin there which has got the pigment in it, and that's what you can see, and that's what sticks to the canvas. Now the more water you add to it, that means the thinner it's going to get, and those little molecules can't hold hands, and it is going to flake or peel over time. It is, and that's why you should always use some sort of a resin based thinning agent. I don't use water, I never use water, and I don't intend to use water. So but if you've, that's all you've got is water, then fine, but just bear in mind these are not going to be archival if you do use water, and they will eventually peel or flake over time. Now that could take 5 years, it could take 10 years, it could take 100 years, I don't know. But there's a possibility it could happen. And I err on the side of caution as always. Okay, so let's stop the waffle and get on to the painting. As you can see, I got my little pot of brushes. These brushes I use in every single lesson. I do not go through them all because I use them different brushes, different styles, different techniques. I'm not going to say exactly what brush that I'm going to use in any specific lesson. I just work through the brushes. I don't know what brushes I'm going to be picking up. So it's, I could give you a list of brushes and then find out I'm using something totally different. So I just tend to just pick up the brush and explain to you what I'm going to be doing as I get along. In this particular instance, I'm going to be picking up a small half inch short flat, getting a bit of moisture onto my greaseproof or parchment paper. It's a wet palette. And I have talked to you about a wet palette, how to design your own wet palette. There I've got a little bit of liquid clear. There you go. You can use a flow improver. This is a liquid clear that I use in my wet and wet techniques. I'm going to be using that today. If you want to have a look at what that is, actually just have a look at the, put in hashtag Clive5Art and see all my videos. If you go into the playlist section, you will see there that I've got some products for sale, or you can go to the website and just go from there. Okay, so I'm picking up some hookers green, and I'm just very lightly just going to put in a very thin green ground into the background. I'm just going to lightly cover that blue. Now the reason I put a blue on the canvas is basically just a little bit of Ceylon blue that I mixed with a bit of gesso, is because I'd already had a previous lesson filmed
on this, and I just wanted to cover up what I already had there. So I'm just putting this in, a little bit of green into the background. There you go. I'm going to leave that little bit of blue there. And this is a native bird of Britain, a little robin redbreast. I've been reading a little bit up on him because I'm going to be using a reference photo in a second of the robin. And I know he's got a red breast, but I'm not too sure on the rest of him. I think he's got like a browny colour wing, but we'll find out. So I'm just scrubbing a little bit of that through. And I'm going to put a bit down here as well. And I'm going to put a bit down there as well. And that's just going to put a little bit of colour in where I need it. Be a bit darker down there. There you go. There's going to be bits of grass and one thing or another. That's all we need to do there, really. Okay. That was simple as that. Yes, so we can develop some darker spots in a second. So we're concentrating mainly on the background. Yes, so let's get the background in first, is it? What I need to do now is, let's have a look. We want a bit of more blue, so I didn't put any blue out on my palette. Why didn't I put blue out? I don't know. I got all my colours all set out here. I'm going to get a little bit of Ceylon blue. So we shall add that to the palette. We only need a touch. I'm going to put it over there. We don't want a lot. Not a lot. Yeah. Bit of moisture. Touch of blue. Bit of moisture. There we go. Get a bit of kitchen roll in your hand. And just put a... It's dark, and I have been asked, do you paint the edges? I don't paint the edges because I don't sell my paintings, and unfortunately most of the paintings I do now at the moment either get painted out, painted over, or put in the bin. I paint basically just now for YouTube, so I can't keep every single painting. I'm just adding a little bit of white. I can't keep every single painting now because I'd have an attic full of them, and I got an attic full already, so my wife's not happy. I'm actually thinking about buying another shed. Yes. I'm going to have to buy another shed because I put all my paintings in. I'm painted. But I do sell some on craft fairs and on the internet and one thing or another. So, you know, some of them I keep, some of them I keep. Some of them I just like lessons like this. I don't know. All depends how nice this one turns out. If he turns out really nice, what I might do is might sell him. I don't know. We'll see. And if that's the case, then I do paint the edges. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to bring a bit of this white over that green like that. So I'm just diffusing that green down. And I won't have to do much to that then, will I? There we go. I get a little bit of blue and I'm going to put a little bit of blue in. Like as if it's a little bit of blue coming through. There we are. There we go. And get some Hooker's Green. Let's get some Hooker's Green. And add a little bit of Van Dyke Brown to that. I'm going to darken that green up with a bit of Van Dyke Brown. Yes. And now what I'm going to do is I'm just going to put in some darker areas like this. I'm going to pick up a little bit of my liquid clear. Just liquid clear. That's going to allow me to just blend through like that. And I just want that speckledy type of look. A touch of white here and there. Just to take a little bit of lightness to it. There you go. The other way you could do this, I'm just darken this side up a minute. I'm enjoying myself today. I'm getting to enjoy myself a lot more now in the studio, and it's fantastic having your company here. It really is. So the other thing you can do is get some, if you've got some liquid clear, you can put some liquid clear straight onto the canvas like that, and I'll just show you that very quickly, because you might have some. If you haven't got it, just use that way like I just showed you. That's fine as well. That works. It just needs a little bit more. A bit more work, that's all it does. This liquid clear just helps speed that process up and just allows for that ease of blending. You get that ease of blending, and you can do it with water, but what you're going to find if you're just using water is that, one, you haven't got that molecular adhesion because you're underbinding your paint, and number two, it dries a lot quicker. Now this doesn't dry very quick, so it allows you to actually blend that in a lot better. Yeah, just bring that in front of that like that. It's not about detail. I'm not worried about detail. I'm more worried about, I'm just going to touch a white to that. I'm just going to sparkle that white up a little bit. I want a little bit lighter there. I just want that. There you go. I'm just play with that. There we are. Just bring that in there. Get a bit of that dark colour down there. There you go. Get yourself a little very, very soft brush. This is a very soft brush. This is actually a paintbrush. It is actually a blending brush, but you can use a makeup brush, as you've heard me say in many a video if you've followed along with me before. And all I'm doing then is just very, very lightly fluffing that in like that. Again, this is more of a Christmas card type of scene. So we're not worried about detail per se. I'm mixing a little bit of Van Dyke Brown back in. I'm just bringing a little bit of Van Dyke Brown in here and there. Now, I did a video the other week explaining how to do blurry backgrounds. And that's not easy for me to say with my teeth. Blurry black backgrounds. So pop along and have a look at that. That's actually in the iCard. You can have a look in the iCards, which is in the top right hand corner of the screen. And this is the first time you've actually watched a video of mine. If you've just happened to pop along and have a look at what I'm doing in the studio. If you have a look down there, there's a little me down there with my thumb up, and you can press that and it'll automatically subscribe you to the channel, which is really fun because not only do I do uploads every week, but I also let you know what's coming up that week. So if you want to follow along with the Sunday podcasts, then that's all well and good. Yes, it's absolutely fantastic. And we're all a happy family here. And I try to give you the free lessons. And if I was actually charging for lessons, then I could be charging as much as £15 to £30 an hour. Yes, that's a lot of money. And that's what I used to charge before. I certainly did. So you're having a good deal, I think, but it's nice to have company in the studio, and I do enjoy your company. And let's just bring a little bit more dark coming in there. What we might do, we might bring a branch of something, maybe, but a bit of holly or something, I don't know. Okay, so let's blend that in. You can see if I do that, it's still wet. So I don't recommend you touching the canvas with your finger because it is grease spots on your finger. Bring in a little bit of white now back into there, and then just bring in a little bit more white. Don't forget that acrylic paint always dries darker. It does. I make sure my eggs on it sharp because I don't want to. I'm going bald. Yes, I'm losing hair. And I didn't realize that until I looked at the back of my head once on the camera, and I thought, oh no, I'm going bald. And I don't like that. It frightens me. But there we are. We can't do much about it. The hair is going to fall out. It's going to fall out. So there's not much I can do about that. So a bit more light there. And I think mainly is because I wear a hat all the time in work. And I do wear hats a lot. I like my hats. My mother says that I get that from my grandfather, who was a Londoner. Yes, he was. And he was typical East Ender. My mother's from the East End in London. Let's just get a little bit of colour in there. And what happens is you talk so much sometimes and you lose your train of thought. Exactly like I did by there. Let me just let that do that. Do his job, a little bit of white here and there like that, just blend that in like there, just like as if, I don't know.
Oh, we can sort that out in a minute. Okay, yeah, put that brush in the pot. I'm going to pick up, I don't know, what am I going to use today? I'm just going to use this one. There we are. I don't know what that is. It's a little short flat. It's a number, it's a half inch short flat. It's another one. Oops. This is a Talon brush. It's a white, it's the white ones. Yes, they're a monofilament, I think. I think they're monofilament. I don't know. I think they are. I'm going to pick up some Van Dyke Brown now. And I'm just going to go and put this fence in. And don't forget, we are following, there's a vanishing point there. And the way I've developed this painting is shown at the end of the video. If you want to pop along at the end, if you wait until the end, I'll take you on the actual development process of how I did this and explaining about the actual vanishing point, because it's got to look as if that's going into the distance, otherwise it's just going to look flat, and that's not what we want. So all I'm doing is the ugly stage now, and is just putting that in there like that. This is called a blockout, and I'm putting the dark in first because I want to put some light on that later on. Now I can see, I've got to remember now that I want to see the top of this, top edge of this fence there, but it's all going to be one color for the moment, so I've got to remember that I don't just forget that, because you can do that quite easily. You can forget things like that, and that's not what I want to do. I want to bring this in now.
Hey, welcome, thanks for stopping by. It's time to learn with our friend Clive. So grab your brush, have a great time.
And this stage is a wonderful stage because it allows you to play with the paint, and you're not committed at this stage, and you can put in some patterns in there. Tell you what you could do, which is quite good. You could let's see, let's have a look. I use a pencil. There we are. I'll just use an ordinary pencil, and I can drag in a couple of lines like this. Just all I'm doing is scraping the paint off and making it look as if it's some sort of wood texture there. You can put a, there you go. Just put a little couple of little lines here and there like that. Just like as if you can see the bark. There you go. So that's a little tip. I'm going to burn umber now. This is a slightly darker, lighter, sorry. It's a slightly lighter colour, because I want to separate this edge from that edge. There's no other reason. It's just I want to just separate that edge. There we go. I'm going back into my Van Dyke Brown now. And I'm just going to continue to block that out there like that. And winter scenes, yes, I've done quite a few this month, being this December, and well, it's winter really, isn't it? It's starting to get really cold here now in Wales, and I don't want to get up for work in the morning. I don't want to get up for work anyway, but even less on a nice cold day like this. And but we've got to go out and earn money, that's a fact. Won't earn itself. There we go. Just putting that down there like that. And again, we can get our pencil. If I can remember where I put it. Where's my pencil? Da-dee-dum. And then we can, let's drag some patterns in like that. There you go. And that'll all become self-evident, I'm sure. Burnt ember now, not burnt ember, sorry, raw ember. I'm just going to go into there. And then into there like that. Again, my pencil. Oh, looks like something now. It certainly does. I'm going to wash my brush. I'm going to pick up a small. Let's have a look what we got in here. What have we got in here today? We got a little detail brush. There we are, look. And I use all the same brushes. If you've painted with me before, you'll know what I'm on about. And this little detail brush. There we go. So number 4. And let's have a look at our robin. So today I've got a reference book. There we go. It's a reference book. And this just happens to be British birds because I live in Britain. So let's see if we can't put our book somewhere safe. Let's just move my tea. That's an important part of my studio equipment is my tea. And let's put my little robin there. And let's get a little bulldog clip. There we are. And let's just hold him there like that. So I can basically copy him. I don't know if you can see it. Yes, you can. Okay, sip of tea, I think. And let's have a little look at him and look at his colour. Okay, so let's get a bit of moisture, and let's get into this. We got this burnt ember, and it looks a little bit red. So I'm gonna add a little bit of red to that burnt ember. I want a red brown. I wanna make it like a sienna type of color, but not as light as that. I want a darker color basically. So I'm just looking at his wing, so I'm just going to block out his wing with that colour. So I've got that brown in there, but I've also got that essence of redness to it. Yeah, just put that in there like that, very, very lightly. I'm just thinking about that. I'm going to add a little bit of white to it. There you go. You can see it's got a bit of a pink tinge to it now. There we are, and I'm gonna do his head like that, and that's gonna come down his neck, and I've got a bit there, a bit there. Let's put this. There you go. Now I'm a crowdfunded site. Yes, I got patrons, and want to know what a patron is, if you want to pop along to the iCards, there's a little thing in there, and it'll take you through and show you what patronage is. And I'm just going to add a little bit of yellow now to a little bit of cardamom red. I want to make an orange color, and there's a crown finding in sight, and I've got quite a few people in there that like helping me out, and basically they're my patrons. In other words, they help a lot with supporting me and allowing me to be able to do these free lessons, because as I said earlier, it costs a lot of money to actually produce something like this. And it's not so much the equipment and stuff like that, it's time is such a big thing. And I got a lot of friends on Facebook and on YouTube, and a lot of creators out there as well, and we're all trying to give as much time as we can. And I mean, not all of us can afford the time to actually do this full time, so we do this part time. By doing it part time, then we're giving up a lot of free resources, and I think it's an absolutely fantastic thing to say that, because I've mentioned this so many times in the past that I'm a great believer in helping people to learn this fantastic skill that is painting. And that's all I want to do, is help as many as I can by doing that. And I'm just putting a little bit of darker. I've just picked up a little bit of burnt umber and just going in there like that. And I'm just putting the underlining colours in. Now I'm going to pick up a little bit of black. And I'm going to pick up a little bit of white. I'm making a grey. As you can have a look at there, I'm picking up a little bit of
flow improver or liquid clear, sorry. And I'm going to put orange to that, a little bit of red. I want to warm that. I want a warm grey. Basically, I'm looking for a nice warm grey. So I made a grey. I'm just adding a little. I just added a touch of, even a little touch of brown. Look, there we are. I want to get that grey, but I want it on a warm side. There you go. That'll do me. That's all I want. I want that. I want a grey type of red colour. There we are. That's not as grey as I wanted it. So let's add a bit more white. Nice. I like that colour actually, that's quite nice. It's a bit more black to that. Let's see what we got now. That's better. That's the colour I wanted, roughly. Doesn't matter, it's just a block out colour. That's okay. And I take my hat off to anybody that does YouTube videos, whether they do art or whether they do helping you with Facebook, or whether there's people out there that show how to fix cars and washing machines and all these, anything you want to learn, anything you want to work out, anything you need help with, there's always a YouTube channel out there or a YouTube video out there that'll help you with these things. It certainly is. There you go. Let's get another brush. Yes, so I got the greatest respect for anybody that makes these videos and helping people like yourselves to learn something new. So I'm picking up a little bit of black. I'm picking up my cork stick. It's just a stick with a bit of cork on. I'm just going to try and develop his eye now, because I want to get a little bit of detail. Do this bird. Not looking for a dead accurate I'm looking for a dead accurate. Hang on, let's just do his. But I want it to look like a robin. Would help if it looked like a robin. I just need to let that dry a little bit first, I think, now. And I'm just going to wash out a couple of brushes. Okay, so I'm going to just pick up a little bit of moisture. I'm going to a bit of white paint. You've seen me do this so many times. Very, very thin. And I'm just going to wash down with a little bit of white at one edge. Just picked up a bit of green. No, that doesn't matter. It looks as if there's something in the distance now. Anyway, let's wash the brush. Let's pick up a little bit of green. Let's put. Something a bit lighter there. That looks alright. Okay,
think we're going to let that dry a little bit now.
Let's have a look and see if we can get some more detail into this wonderful little bird, which is a robin. He's got a distinctive red breast, yes, that's what it says, yeah. He's about 13 to 14 centimetres, which is about 5 and 5.5 inches. And he's got an 8.5 inch wingspan. And they breed in March.
Yes, I didn't know that.
Okay, so I'm just reading that out of the book. Not that I'm not that knowledgeable. Okay, so let's get a little bit of that burnt umber now. And then all I'm going to do now is bring in very, very lightly. Darkening this edge here and just develop a little bit of shape now, and I'm just going to put a little line just down like that, so it's like this little shoulder before it comes into here, and he's going to have a little bit of shadow under there, so I'll use the same colour but I'll use it as a shadow colour. Yeah, just get a little bit more moisture on my brush. I'm just very, very lightly just pushing that. I'm trying to blend as you go. You can blend as you go. I'm trying to get a little bit of shape there. I'm just go into a bit more orange now. I want to go a brighter orange. I want to bring that colour up. Lighten it a bit. Go around his eye. I'm going to orange that up again. Brighter orange. Added a little bit more yellow to that mix. And I'm bringing that down. I'm not worrying about putting in feather shapes at the moment, because all I'm doing at the moment is just underlining colour. That's all I'm painting, is the underlining colour. I'm trying to get some shadow in there. I'm using a little bit of moisture, my medium mix flow improver. I'm also using a little bit of my liquid clear, because that helps bring in a bit of orange down like that. And he's still red in there, but that burnt umber is giving me that shadow colour. And again, I'm picking a bit of that up, and I'm going to put that bit of that under his wing there like that as a shadow colour, and I'm very, very lightly just stroking down with a brush. Now this warm grey, again I'm going to lighten that up, and I'm going to put a bit of a lighter colour, but I'm not destroying all the darker colour underneath. This acrylic's dry dark. Just remember that. It's important when you're painting with acrylics, you remember they dry at least one or two shades darker. So you remember that when if you remember that when you're painting, it makes life a lot easier. I'm just stroking the canvas with the tips of the brush. But I'm thinking about little lines now. I'm just putting lines in like this, like that, to represent some sort of feather shape. So the dark colour now is turning into my under feathers. Yes, and we've got to find his tail. It's going to be down there somewhere like that. There you go. Yep. That's all I'm looking at. And again, let's put some of these lighter marks now. Just the ear in there on his wing area, like that. And let's get that light colour down. Let's get rid of that black line. And then let's think about his claw. That's going to come down there like that, roughly. And there's going to be another one like that. That one's going to be up there like that, I expect. It doesn't really matter. There you go. I'll adjust that in 1 second. He's going to have another one. He's going to have one there. He's going to have one there. Should have one there. Maybe one like that. I don't know. Looks a bit weird at the moment, but we'll get there. And that's what it's all about sometimes. We just play around with that. We're going to paint over this anyway, so that doesn't matter. We'll work that one out in a second. I don't like that one. I'm gonna put another one there, maybe something like that. I don't know. We'll work it out. Okay. Wash our brush. Let's concentrate on shadow again. So I'm going to get a bit of burnt umber, Van Dyke Brown together. And now I'm just very, very lightly, there's very, very little paint on my brush. I'm going to go from the eye out like that. Very, very little paint. Very, very little paint on my brush. Very, very little paint. I just want to. Develop a bit of shadow there. There you go. A bit of burnt umber. Let's darken down. Doesn't look quite right. Okay, so what we're going to do with that, we're going to put a bit of green, and let's put a bit of green in. Let's tighten that up there like that. If you make a mistake, you can overpaint, so don't worry about it. We just need to re-establish the shape of our head, and we can play around with this. We can adjust the greens. So let's just concentrate now, don't worry about this area. That's just green. We can play with the green. We can merge that in later. I want to get the shape of that head correct first. Yeah, that's a bit better. And then just blend that in back in to the green. There we are. We think we've just about recovered that. Okay, so I want to get a bit of orange. So we've got a bit of orange there. There you go. And again, going to this light grey. Let's get rid of that whiteness. There, like that. A bit of Van Dyke.
Hey, welcome, thanks for stopping by. It's time to learn with our friend Clive. So grab your brush, have a great time. And don't forget to click subscribe. Visit Clive5Art.co.uk.
It's starting to develop pretty good. I can spend a lot of time on this actually, and I'm going to try and get this as nice as I can. So I'm sitting on a really strange angle, and so I need to concentrate now. It's a bit of a Billy Carroll's. I would, if I had any. And because I mix a bit of yellow ochre, a bit of yellow together into that orange colour, and I want to sparkle that up a bit. I'm going to mix a bit of white to it actually. There you go. On a brighter colour now. Better. This looks as if it's just catching the light a bit. I'm doing some very, very fine, very, very fine lines now.
Then I pick up some Van Dyke Brown on the same brush. I haven't washed my brush yet, so I'm just mixing all these colours actually on the brush, and I'm just gonna lightly just draw in some very thin lines. And you need to make sure that the paint is thin for this. I haven't got hours and hours and hours that I could spend actually doing the detail work on this robin as much as I would like to. I won't have the time, but I want to get it to a point that I'm happy with it, because it could spend literally hours and hours just with little tiny little brushes like this if I was painting this myself. Just put a little bit of highlight there like that. I'm using a very tip of this brush. To get some shape in. Now I'm going to mix another grey. I'm going to mix some white and black together. A little bit of yellow ochre to it. There we are. Again, getting that very thin. I want to load this brush up. These little brushes, they do not hold a lot of water or paint, I should say. I'm very lightly going in. I want to make it a bit lighter, add a bit more white. And I want to whiten that again. Wow, sometimes it takes a lot more white than you think to get the effect that you want. So very lightly. I'm just touching. Up a little bit of that Van Dyke Brown colour, just a touch on just a tip on my brush, sorry. Go, it's getting tongue-tied, yeah. And I'm just gonna leave that at that for the moment. I'm gonna get a little bit of that orange. I'm gonna lighten it right down. I want to make it more of a pink. Again, using exactly the same brush. And now let's have a look at this. His feet. Okay, so we're going to go have one there like that, and they got little claws, and they got a bit like that. That one is going to come up more that way, and that one is going to come more that way. So they got three main toes, and then one at the back. So basically, it looks like that. See, there you go. So we've got three main toes, and that one is coming off the back there like that. I mean, I'll leave him as he is now. I want him to dry. Okay, we got enough detail in there that I'm happy with for the moment. Okay, so what I'm going to do now is get my half inch short flat, going back up to the top part of the wet palette, which I made that little whitewash with earlier on. I'm going to pick up a bit of yellow ochre. I'm going to mix in that in there. I'm going to pick up a bit of burnt umber. I'm going to mix a bit of that in there because I want to darken it off. I don't want it to be too bright, but I don't want it to be too dark. So that's basically all I'm doing, is a nice thin 80%, 20%. 80% fluid, medium, or water if you've got it, but I, as I said, I don't recommend you use just water, and I'm just going to go very lightly now over that wood like that. And over this area as well. And what we're going to do then is get the hairdryer on that. Picking up my detail brush again, I'm just picking up a bit of Van Dyke Brown. And I'm going to go in and just pull a few branches out like that. Some twigs, and doesn't have to be anywhere really, doesn't matter, just a few little lines like that. There you go, I'll do for the moment. I'm going to bring in one there, and I'm going to bring in maybe one there later on, so I'm just putting that, establishing that in there for the moment. Going into another little short flat, this is a number 8, and I'm just going to pick up some Van Dyke Brown now. I'm just checking my head, it's not in shot. I want to darken this edge completely here. Really want to get that nice and dark there. Putting on the paint a little bit thicker now, a bit like soft butter really. Making sure you get that edge as nice and sharp and crisp as you can down there, because that's the front edge. So these are going into the side. These bars are going to the side, so you need to define that there. And it doesn't matter if the paint's on a little bit thick, you want it like soft butter really. And then you can put a, that piece there is going to be darker as well. Drag that in. A bit of shadow then. So you need to darken that little bit there. Just darken that edge. Define that edge. Again with that one. Make sure you follow that perspective line. And a bit of a shadow there. That's going to be darker in there as well. Now we need to establish this. But don't forget, I could have forgotten that. And I know I keep saying this, but you certainly have got a lot more time than I have as far as detailing is concerned. So please, 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 if you don't do nothing else, it just take your time. You don't need to do it in the same time scale as myself. I'm trying to do these lessons as accurate as I can in the time scale as I got. I'm just going to pull that down. This a little bit darker now. I'm adding a little bit of water, a little bit of moisture to my brush. I want to thin that paint down. I want this darker, so I'm just going to darken in certain areas of that area there, like like that. And again, a similar type of thing on the top here. Oops, big clumpy bits. Watch, you don't pick up too much paint on your brush. Needs a nice sharp edge. And then just blade that up. Go. It's looking quite nice. Now, what we could do, use the same brush, get some Hooker's Green, and just tap your brush into some Hooker's Green, and then just put some marks like this. Anywhere you want. Try not to make them too big, okay? We get a small detail brush straight into some red, and just here and there, and there and here, put a few little red spots, red spots, here and there, just to represent maybe. A couple of berries and it's a mass of colour. It doesn't have to be individual berries, you could have a pile of berries there, but because they're so distant, it looks like one big mass of red. There we go. That's going to pull your eye in. Yes, it certainly will. Wash that brush. You can just take the moisture off that brush and then just dry brush in, just dry brush in, just dry brush in a little bit of green here and there like that. Distance, and all I'm doing is just dry brushing in a little bit of green, darkening a few areas. Get that little touch more. Take it off like that. Just you can just put a few more distantly looking things, and you can bring a little bit darker in here if you wanted to. Spread it in. Just play around with your background a little bit. To give it a little bit more realism there. Okay, again, let's get a little bit of moisture on your brush, go into the bit of that green, and let's just do a little wash, put a little colour wash just on the bottom there like that. Don't forget, this is a Christmassy card type of scene, that's what we're looking for. We're not looking for total accuracy, doesn't really matter. All we're looking for is a nice pleasing subject, a nice pleasing painting to the eye. That's all we're looking for. And this is why this is so much fun sometimes to do. There we go. I'm going to let that dry. Okay, so I've let that dry, and it looks a bit weird down there. I noticed, I just come back in now, because when you're sitting on top of a painting, you miss simple little things sometimes, and that is one of them. So I'm just going to get some Van Dyke Brown, and I'm going to bring in another bar across there, like that. Now you're not going to see a lot of this bar. There you go. That's going off canvas, because what I'm going to do is I'm going to put a lot of grasses and stuff in, maybe a bit of holly or something there now in the second. So basically just make it look as if there's another fence or something, but there you go. That's all we need to worry about. I'm going to bring in a bit of the lighter colour into that as well now, just to, and that's all I'm going to do. I'm not going to worry too much about detailing that at all, because I'm going to put grass and stuff in there in a minute. But I want to just go back in onto the robin now and do a little bit more detail work in there. So I just want to warm it up, put a few more feathers in and one thing or another. So that's what we're going to do now. And then we'll see what happens after that, I think. So let's do a little bit more work onto this robin. Let's now put some distinctive little lines like that there. I don't know if you can see, we've got some little lines there. We got some lines there, so I'm going to try and go as close to that as possible now. So I just want to increase a couple of little lines in across the top of the head. He's quite going to be quite dark here, so I just a little bit of moisture, and I'm just going to very, very lightly wash in just a little bit of colour. Like a glaze, then that's what we're looking for. There's a bit of a glaze there and a little bit of a red tinge to it as well. So we'll just do that. I want to go back into his crop. This is his crop here. I just want to warm that through. I put a little bit more red, a little bit of water, a bit of moisture, a medium mix flow improve, a bit of liquid clear, whatever you want to use. And I just want to warm up his chest a bit now, because we want him, he's a Christmas robin, so he's going to be nice and bright. And he's courting his girlfriends now already, because he's thinking, yeah, won't be long before March is here. And I've got they're very territorial birds, on robins, they really are. Let's do his leg now. Just playing around with some colours. It's just all the colours we used earlier. And maybe I should use my smaller brush. I'm going to go in a bit of black. I'll put his nail in that lad. A bit of a nail there. A bit of a nail there. Put a bit of shadow under his talons a little bit there, like that. Back into dark black. A bit of shadowing underneath. What I've done, I thinned my paint down really well, just using a very damp brush. And all I'm going to do, all I'm doing is just putting a little bit of shadow, very, very thin glaze basically, on that. And I'm just going to put a couple of black lines here and there like that. Let's get into this colour we made earlier, that warm grey. We've lightened it right up and get that brush nice and loaded, making sure it's got a nice sharp point. And what we're going to do now is bring in a bit lighter. Play with the colours. If it's not the colour you want, don't keep on doing it, just lighten it up if you want to. That's my rule. Ponging. Boing. Just bring in a couple of little loose little feathers here just to give it a little bit of a realistic feel. And this is not the only robin I painted this year. I actually did paint one for the Patreon site, like I said, and if you want to know what a patron is, then please press the iCards. But it's a public funded site where people come along and they fund me for as little as 67p a month. 67 pence a month. Wow, that's about $1 a month. And there's quite a lot of patrons in there that actually give a little bit of a helping hand to me, and I do appreciate it because it does help me pass these lessons on to people like yourself totally free of charge. And I enjoy immensely your company in the studio, and I also enjoy sharing my little bit of knowledge that I've gained being self-taught over the years, like many people, never gone to college and nothing like that. I mean, it's just a process of hard work. That's all it is. Yes. That's all I'm going to do to Mr. Robin Redbreast today. I'm now going to concentrate on the little bit in the bottom right hand corner here. Okay, as I promised, let's get a brush. I'm just going to use this detailing brush, and I'm just going to pick up some green, and I'm just going to put a couple of marks like this here and there. Nothing too special, just representation. There you go. That's all I'm going to do. Tell you what would be fun. I tell you what would be fun. I wonder if we could do that. We could. We could do that, actually. I'm going to wash that brush now. What I'm going to do, and I'm going to put a little bit of snow on the top of this post. And then across there, like that. A little bit under there. Pull that down. Because this is a Christmas scene and a winter scene, so why not? Let's just put a bit of snow in like that. Let's put a bit of snow as if it's caught on there. And let's put a bit of snow in there like that. And just pull that very, very lightly. Just dry brush that in. Like as if it's a little bit of. Snow just caught here and there. That's all you need to do. That's all you need to do. And I tell you what would be fun. If we got a. We got one of these. This is a little scrubby little brush. And I do. You see me using these on landscapes and things. I'm just going to pick up a little bit of white. I'm going to tap that out. Get us off. Get a little bit off of that. And I'm just going to put a little bit of white here and there like that. I'm going to get my little brush. Where's my little brush gone? There he is. Okay. Again, a little bit of brush, a little bit of paint on my brush. I'm going to just put a little bit of whiteness here and there like that. That's what you need to do. Don't need a lot. Your eye will make up that it's snow. And that's really nice. That's looking nice. We can increase the snow there, and we can hide his feet. There you are. That's one way of hiding his feet. A little bit of snow. I guess gathered on top of that post there, that fence. That's good. And let's just bring in some green. Let's just touch a bit of white on the one bit of that, and let's just put a little bit of whiteness in to this holly, because that's what it is. It's holly. Holly and the ivy. Yes. Holly and the ivy. Let's just increase the. Let's just touch. You don't have to worry. This is a Christmas card scene. All you have to worry about here is that it looks Christmassy. Because painting this type of thing is about fun, relaxation, and it's just immense fun, actually. It's just immense fun. It really is. There's a couple of thicker areas here and there, like as if it's a little clump. There you go. And you can pull up some, let's mix a little bit of white with that. Let's just pull up some maybe grass or something there, come in into play. There we are. Whatever, it doesn't matter, does it? It doesn't matter. Just put some little effects there like that. There we go. Little effects, blades of grades of grass or something. There you go, like that. And we could get some red on the tip of our brush. Put some berries in, because he's looking at those berries and he's thinking, I might have a couple of them for my tea. That's what he's looking for, is those berries. He is. Just good compliments. And I'm going to pick up, if I can find it, a strip liner brush, because I did have one earlier. There he is. And I'm going to pick up a bit of a Van Dyke brown. I'm just going to mix a little bit of white with it, because I want a little, to show the difference. I mixed a lot of medium mix flow improver with that. And what I'm going to do is, I'm just going to put in a couple of twigs there, here and there. Here and there, and there and here. A bit more white. You're in there. And there in you. You can put a couple in the background. Like that. You can bring a bit of white on the very tip of your brush. Bring a bit of white on the very tip of your brush. Doesn't have to be perfectly white, it doesn't matter. And just highlight a couple of these little branches, like as if they've caught a bit of snow. There you go. Bit frosty. That's fine. Get some more green on the tip of that brush. There we go. Just change my brush. I've just put another mass of green in. There you go. There we are. And what would be fun before we finish this is if we make it snow. Okay, so how do we make it snow, Clive? Well, what we need to do is possibly get a fan brush like that. Yes. And pick up a bit of white. Doesn't matter. Pick up a bit of white. Get that nice and thin. And there's two ways we can do this. The first way is very, very gently, as you pull this towards you like that, and you get a little bit of snow falling. Or you could just use your finger and just tap in a few little flicky bits like that. It does make a mess. But a little bit of snow in the background like that. Bit of snow in the background like that. There we are. It looks as if it's just started to snow. There you go. And if you're very, very quick, you just get your brush, wet it, and just get those snow spots, those little flakes of snow, off the robin, like that, because you don't want to ruin him. You worked hard. There you go. That was a little bit big. We can get rid of him. Can make him noises. Yes, you are. I'm going to have to get a new shirt. Tina, I'm ruining your shirt. I'm full of pink spots. Yes. Tina is a fantastic person. She's a family member, and she's a subscriber since the beginning. And she does all my shirts for me. So thank you very much, Tina. Have a nice Christmas. You and your husband. Thank you very much for supplying my shirts throughout the year. And please like, comment, and subscribe. That's the most important thing as well. Please like, comment, and subscribe if you like this little painting. And please leave comments in the comment box below if there's anything you want to know, anything you want to ask me, please do that. I'm going into a little bit of that burnt umber and white mix. I'm using my strip liner brush, as I said. And yes, please leave a comment. Give me a thumbs up. That's important as well. Pop along to clivesfiveart.co.uk, where you'll see all my lessons there. I'm in the process of upgrading that at the moment, but you'll see all my shop items. And all it remains for me to do today is just put my name in the bottom right-hand corner like that, and sign that off. And all it remains for me to say is thank you very much for joining me in the studio today. My name is Clive from clivesfiveart.co.uk. Have a good day, good week, good month, a good year. May God go with you. God bless, and I'll see you in the studio for another lesson. Bye-bye.
Hey, welcome, thanks for stopping by. It's time to learn with our friend Clive. So grab your brush, have a great time. And don't forget to click subscribe. Visit clive5art.co.uk.
Hello, and thank you for joining me in the studio today. I thought I would do something different today. I want to plan a painting ready for a video. And I just wanted to show you roughly how I go along with it. I normally start with an idea. This is my idea. There you go. So I was thinking of some sort of a fence, maybe going that way. This is going to be a Christmassy scene, and I was going to put, I don't know, a bird, a robin, red breast, or something like that. But there, basically. So I'm just going to try and develop that idea in my head. I don't know if there's anything going to be in this corner,
We're trying to use the rule of thirds, and Dawn and I have discussed this on a video on Paint and Chat, where it is your canvas is actually divided up by two horizontal, two verticals, and you need to get your subject just off in one of these boxes, any one of these boxes. Really, you don't want anything really dead in the center because it's not going to quite look right. But you're also going to need some sort of a focal point, and I was thinking of putting a post or something there and going into perspective. Then perspective is basically like lines on a railway track. So you've got an horizon line, you've got a point, a fixed point. So if there's anything going to be here, to get that feeling distance, it's got to hide. It's got to actually follow that line there. So if I'm going to put a post here, the actual fence and bars, I should say, have got to go into a vanishing point. In other words, if that's the bar, it's going to go slightly off, and it's going to get slightly narrower, just to give it that essence of going into a distance point. So you don't just draw a line like that, because it wouldn't look right. So what we're trying to say is that you've got to have a little bit of difference to it, because that looks a lot better than that. If you just draw that does look as if it's going. So obviously if we're going to put a bird then or something there, right, doesn't look like a bird, but you know what I mean, then he's going to have a little bit of perspective to him as well. Yes, so this is basically what I was thinking of doing, was to have some sort of a post there with the actual fence bars going somewhere like that, and just a plain background, maybe just a bird. And well, we'll play around with that idea, but that's how I actually look at a planning a painting. So let's see if we can't get that into some sort of stage. So breaking down my canvas, I'm going to need the major fence post there, and the bars are going to have to go. I need one there, I'm going to need one there, so they're going to have to go to a vanishing point like that, and that's going to follow the same vanishing point like that. There's going to have to be another one along there. You're not going to see the top of that one. You're not going to see the bottom of that one. You're going to see the top of that one. That's going to be coming out of this side, and then that side as well. And we're going to need to develop some sort of a post, which again is going to have to be in perspective. And we're going to have to put some sort of a bird on there. So what I'm going to continue doing that, and when it's done, we'll start the lesson. Hello, and I quickly want to talk about my retarder and flow improver that I've developed. Now, there are other ones on the market, but I personally like using these because they are my product. So I'm a little bit biased, yes. But look, if you want to have a try, then please try that. And a retarder stops your paint from drying out, whereas the flow improver makes the paint move across the surface of your painting a little bit easier. Yes, available on my website www.kai5art.co.uk. If you want to press the iCard there, that's going to take you into a playlist section where you're going to see all my other products as well, such as Liquid Clear, Blending White, etc., Fine Mist Bottle, and all that. Now, these are available, as I said, as a package. Now, you can pick and match these if you want to. I've got Liquid Clear, Retarder, Fine Mist Bottle, Blending White, so all that there. It is actually as a package as well. So please pop along to my website, www.clyfiveart.co.uk, and press the relevant buttons, and you'll see little videos come up, and they'll explain everything in a little bit more detail. Yes, but I'm waffling too much.